Imagine a creature about the size of your hand, with long, hairy legs. It's not a tarantula. Tarantulas are pretty slow. This animal can run as fast as you can. It has large pinchers. And in legend, it would feed on camels by attacking their stomachs. This could be none other than... Well, find out after the theme song. This creature from the Middle East is a legend. Hiding in sleeping bags, eating camels, fighting to the death, venomous. Well, some of that may be true. It's not all true. So let's get some facts. This animal is the camel spider, but it's, first of all, not a spider nor a camel. It does not eat camels, so there's a lot of confusion with its name. We will call it the camel spider, even though it's not a camel or a spider, does not eat camels. They are huge, scary, and quite interesting. So first of all, camel spider bites are nasty. So if someone's bitten by or another bug is bitten by a camel spider, they're pretty nasty, but not venomous so that it'll kill you at least. But they can leave quite a wound. The bites can cause a massive amount of pain and terrible infections. Camel spiders use digestive fluids to liquefy their victim's flesh. Hopefully that victim is not you. Camel spiders are skilled fighters. They can easily take down other insects their size, even scorpions. Can you imagine an animal that can kill a scorpion? I know some can, but those are pretty tough creatures. And this one, it's like a scorpion without the stinger. Oh, they're so big. Most full-grown camel spiders are about the size of a credit card. In the Middle East, they can get up to 10 inches long. So if you see one, you should really run. But speaking of running, they're fast. They're really fast. They've been recorded at 10 miles per hour. That's 16 kilometers per hour. That is very fast. If you're speedy, you might be able to outrun them. But for the rest of us who are not as fast, I don't know what we're going to do. Maybe we'll just get some shovels. They're actually more common than I realized. When I look at a map, a range map, by the way, a range map shows an area where an animal or a plant may live. They're very helpful to me. When I look at this range map of camel spiders, I can see that they live in Northern Africa, all the way down into the south, all of the Middle East, that would be Southwestern Asia and Southeastern Europe. They are in South America, and they are also in Southwestern United States and Mexico. I don't know how many there are in those regions, probably not as many, but that's where they've been found. In previous legend, it was believed that camel spiders attacked camels. Actually, the reason the camel spider got its name is because they are frequently found under camels. One of the myths was that they would jump onto a camel's stomach and eat it alive. That's terrifying to think about, but in reality, these spiders just gather under camels for shade. I don't know why that's so funny, but it is. They're gathering for shade. The poor things. It's hot. You guys could move to a cooler climate if you wanted. Anyway, they gather under the camels for the shade, supposedly, not to eat the camels. So they're camel spiders. So when you see a camel, before you go to it, look underneath. If there's something there, run. Run for dear life. Listeners, I'm not sure if the camel spider is more terrifying than I could have imagined, or less terrifying because they don't actually eat the camels, they just hide under them for shade. I think a part of me feels like, okay, they're just a normal animal trying to find comfort and food. They're hiding under a camel for shade. That's kind of comical and a little relieving and almost endearing. Endearing is definitely an overstatement, though, when you look at a picture of them. There's not really anything endearing about them. I guess it's like people. Some people, including myself, might seem very abrasive and disturbing. But we can find something about them, something about ourselves, to enjoy or to appreciate. And no matter what, God is at work in us, helping us. So whether you ever see a camel spider or not, we can remember it's just an animal trying to survive. People are doing the same thing, trying to survive. More than that, trying to thrive. You know, there's something different about animals than people, though. Animals are trying to survive. People, through community and through connection to God and His nature, are trying to thrive. Find something in your life where you can thrive. That means you're not just surviving, but you are creating, you are growing. Do something to create and give to others. Do something good. Help someone else feel better. You don't just need to hide under a camel in the shade. You can do something good. More than surviving, you can thrive. And now it's time for our mystery sound. It's been a long time. Let's have a mystery sound and see if you can guess what the upcoming sound is. Do you have any ideas what that could be? It could be one of thousands of creatures I know. I'll give you a hint. It's native to Pennsylvania. There's a big hint for you. Listeners, thank you for joining me. I am enjoying being able to record with you again. I'm Moose Jaw Matt. Until next time, keep exploring your... Wait a minute! Listeners, I want to remind you, if you haven't checked out our website, moosejawmatt.com, do that right now. If you are not supporting the podcast by sharing with others, leaving reviews, or supporting financially on Patreon, you are very welcome to do so. Please send in ways in which you are exploring your world, and I will share it on a future episode. For example, if you've been out hiking recently, or you went out and you watched a snail, something about science and nature, maybe you have magnets you like to play with, anything, please share what you do to explore your world, and I'll put it on a future episode. All right, now we can continue with the song. Bye-bye.